On Tuesday, Chris Conger took a BBC film unit to the location where 20th Century Vole are shooting their latest epic, Scott of the Antarctic.
Sea, sand and sunshine make Paynton the queen of the English Riviera. But for the next 6 months, this sleepy Devonshire resort will be transformed into the blizzard-swept wastes of the South Pole. For today, shooting starts on the epic Scott of the Antarctic, produced by Jerry Schlick.
Hello.
Jerry, you chose Paynton as the location for Scott.
Right.
Isn't it a bit of a drawback that there's no snow here?
Well, we have 28,000 cubic feet of Wintrex, which is a new white foam rubber, which actually on screen looks more like snow than snow. And 1,600 cubic US furlongs of white paint with a special snow finish.
And I believe Kirk Vild is playing the title role.
That is correct. We were very thrilled and honored when Kirk agreed to play the part of Lieutenant Scott, because a star of his magnitude can pick and choose. But he read the title and just flipped. And directing, we have a very fine young British director, James McCretin, who's been collaborating on the screenplay, of course. Jimmy.
Oh, here you are. Hello, no problem. Have a drink. Oh, great. Hello, marvellous. Hello. Really nice. Oh, this is really great. I mean, it's really saying something, don't you think?
Have you started shooting yet?
Yes. Great. Perfect. No, we haven't started yet. No, but great.
What is the first scene that you shoot this morning?
Great. Perfect. Oh, it's great. No problem. We'll sort it out on the floor. No problem. This film is basically pro-humanity and anti-bad things. And it rips aside the hypocritical facade of our society's gin and tonic and leaves a lot of sacred cows rolling around in agony. Have a drink.
But which scene are we shooting first, Jimmy?
Yes. Great. Oh, marvellous. Well, which scene are we shooting first? What, it's C1. C1. It's in the middle of the movie. Well, it is now, and you wrote it. It's absolutely... I thought we'd cut that. Did we cut?
No, we didn't.
We didn't? Oh, great, that's even better. I'll put it back in. Rewrite, C1's back in, everyone. C1's back in. Great, this is the scene. That's outside the tent. Ah, it's so bloody marvellous. It makes you want to throw up.
Now, in this scene, Lieutenant Scott returns to camp in the early morning after walking the Huskies to have brunch with the rest of his team. Oates, played by your very own lovely Terence Lemming, who is an English Cockney officer seconded to the US Navy, and Bowers, played by Seymour Fortescue, the Olympic pole vaulter.
Hi, Lieutenant.
Hi, Oatsy. Sure is a beautiful day already.
Greet! What are you saying? I'm just saying greet! Two heavens!
And this is Vanilla Whore as Miss Evans.
Miss Evans?
Right.
Good morning, Miss Evans.
Oh, I've forgotten my line.
Oh, what's her line?
Good morning, Captain Scott.
Oh, yeah. Good morning, Captain. Oh, I'm just not really very happy with that line. Could I just say, hi, Scotty?
Great, be right. You.
Hi, Scotty. Oh, sorry. Hi, Stocky. Oh, I'm sorry again. Oh, Jim, I'm just not happy with this line. Hey, can I do it all sort of kooky like this? Hi, Scotty!
Great, we'll do it.
Are you sure that's right?
Oh, it's great.
Jim!
Oh, me.
Jim, I feel we may be running into some problems here in the area of height.
Great, where are they?
Where are who?
I don't know, I was getting confused.
Jim, I feel here that Scott may be too tall in the area of height with reference to Vanilla, who is too near the ground in the area of being too short at this time.
Gee.
Oh, I know! I'm going to dig a pit for Scott and put a box in Vanilla's trench.
Say, why don't I take the boxes off and Vanilla get up out of the trench?
Wouldn't work. It's even better. Gee, you're right.
What was that?
easy. I worked it out. Scott takes his boxes off, and you don't stand in the trench.
I save my lines out of the trench?
Isn't that great?
But I've never acted out of a trench. I might fall over. It's dangerous.
Oh, well, could you just try it?
Look, you crumb bum. I'm a star. Star, star, star. I don't get $1 million to act out of a trench. I play Miss John the Baptist in a trench. And I've played Miss Napoleon Bonaparte in a trench. And I've played Miss Alexander Fleming in a furrow. So if you want this scene played out of a trench, will you just get yourself a goddamn stuntman? Huh. Played Miss Galileo in a groove. And I played Mrs. Jesus Christ in a geological syncline. I don't
know how to act. I don't have to act. Greet, greet, everyone. Our lunch now. Lunch. It's all in the can. Good morning's work.
You haven't done a shot.
I just keep morale.
Now, this afternoon, we're going to shoot the scene where Scott gets off the boat, onto the ice floe, and he sees the lion, and he fights it, and he kills it, and the blood goes in slow motion.
But there aren't any lions in the Antarctic.
What?
There aren't any lions in the Antarctic.
You're right. There are no lions in the Antarctic. That's ridiculous. Who ever heard of a lion in the Antarctic? Right, lose the lion.
Gotta keep the lion, it's great.
Lose the lion.
Great, well, losing the lion, be right. Lose the lion, everyone. That's fantastic.
Hey, what's this about, losing the lion?
Well, Kirk, we thought perhaps we might lose the fight with the lion a little bit, Kirk Angel.
Why?
Well, Kirky doll, there are no lions in the Antarctic, baby.
I get to fight the lion.
It'd be silly.
Listen, I gotta fight the lion. That's what that guy Scott's all about. I know, I studied him already.
Well, why couldn't you fight a penguin?
Fight a penguin?
It needn't be a little penguin. It can be the biggest penguin you've ever seen. An electric penguin, 20 feet high, with long green tentacles that sting people. And you can stab it in the wings and the blood can go spurting in slow motion.
The lion is in the contract.
He fights the lion.
He's fat. Great. Oh, great. Hey, lose the penguin. Stand by to shoot.
Lion.
Africa.
That's it. Scott's in Africa. As many lions as we need.
Scott's
deep in a hole no one else knows about. That ties in with the sand. Right, paint the sand yellow again. Okay, let's get this show on the road. Scott of the Sahara.
Sea Ensign Ops's frank adult death struggle with the spine-chilling giant electric penguin.
Now for something completely different.
It